Welcome back to Ideology Explained. Today I will tell you about another variant of the centrally planned economy. This time it is planned by AI rather than by humans. As I defined it last time, a planned economy can be summarized as an economic system in which the distribution of resources is taken over by a centralized institution, in this case an AI. That means artificial intelligence for my non-tech-savvy audience. It's basically the same thing as a centrally planned economy. Stuff gets produced in some way, the planning institution has no influence on the how, and then the AI manages the distribution. This is very much the modern approach to a Soviet-style planned economy, except better for reasons I will get into in a moment. It allows central management, which is very good if you like to avoid waste. Remember, the free market overproduces so much that up to 40% of everything that is produced gets thrown away before being bought or used. A centrally planned economy avoids that. And an AI planned economy would be even better at that. Remember what the downsides of the centrally planned economy were? This is one of the main problems with the planned economy. It gives few people the power to plan the entire economy. Another problem with the planned economy can be human error. Well, with the good AI, both of those would be solved. Humans can be very bad at planning ahead and predicting changes in demand, which is why the Soviet Union had an 8-year waiting period for cars at one point. But theoretically, an AI would not have that problem. And an AI wouldn't be corrupt either, so that's not an issue. But of course, there are problems, as always. One is that AI like that has yet to be written or even simulated. I happen to go to an IT school, so I know a bit about that. Basically, it would be a self-teaching AI. The idea is that you show the AI a lot of data, and it analyzes it and searches for patterns. If you give it enough data, at one point, even the people who programmed it don't know how it works anymore. And of course, that means it can make good decisions which humans wouldn't come up with. Though my semi-professional opinion on that is that it could be very dangerous to trust the entire global, or just national, economy to a black box which nobody understands. And nobody can understand. AI always does something different from how you want it to act. If you want an example, look at the YouTube demonetization bot. It does something, and nobody can explain why. Of course, this may sound like I'm scared of technology, but I'm really not. I just think we should be very careful about how much we want to trust a single system. What if it makes the wrong decision? What if it develops biases? Yeah, that can happen. Because of the way they are programmed, many AIs take on the biases of the people who programmed them. The reasons for that is out of the scope of this video. And what if there's a power outage? Will our entire global trading system grind to a halt if our central supercomputer goes offline? What if it is to say that technology will allow such a powerful AI? Moore's law is basically made up, so don't cite that. An AI which would plan the entire economy would need an incredibly detailed understanding of the world. It would have to know about weather patterns in order to predict droughts and about future demand of products. That takes huge amounts of computing power. All of those questions can be answered, but we need to ask them before we can apply a system like that. In conclusion, an AI planned economy is basically a planned economy without the downsides, but with more uncertainty about how it would work. There are many questions which have yet to be answered, though I have to admit that none of them seem like impossible challenges. Unless you're an anarcho-primitivist, in which case the system is not for you. A big thanks to my patrons for motivating me to make videos, and an extra special thanks to Aaron J. Patton. Thanks for watching, see ya!